The first day of school can be nerve-wracking for kids, let alone the parents. The first ever day of school is incredibly scary to a lot of kids. Chris Perry is here this morning as the executive director of First Five California with her top five tips on how to make the transition a little easier for everyone.
Hi, I am.
I was trying to remember back to my first day of school, and I don't remember.
Oh,
I don't.
Well,
I guess that's good. It must not have been too traumatic.
It must not have been that long ago, right?
Oh, even better. High five for you. I like that.
Yeah.
So is it a big deal for a lot of kids?
Well, it could be. If you haven't been to preschool or it is your first day of preschool, there's a lot of new activity that's about to happen. And it's really helpful as a parent if you rehearse a little bit of what that first day is going to be like. Standing in line, having a teacher, sitting in a circle, being cooperative. It's really
good. So is that all about reducing the stress factor?
It reduces stress because that then is a familiar activity when they get there. It's
so
not
role
brand
play
new.
Some of these things. Check off the immunizations.
Right. You must be immunized to enter public school kindergarten in the state of California. If you've gotten behind, it's okay. Go to your doctor. Let them know you want to catch up. And if you don't have insurance, there are free vaccination programs.
Get it out of the way early.
Get it done early, yes.
Okay. This is a big one. Eat right, because if you have the brain food in you, your brain is more likely to work later on.
Absolutely. Now, think about how important it is to get lots of sleep. But while you're sleeping, you're using energy, and when you wake up, you need to really eat a healthy breakfast so that your sugar levels are high all day, because food is actually brain food and helps your child focus and concentrate.
A little protein will really get the brain in gear.
It really does.
Yeah, I know it works for us, sometimes it works for us around here. Practice the basic skills. Are you talking about the actual, like, the colors and the letters and all that kind of thing?
Absolutely. You're doing everything from holding scissors and crayons and paintbrushes to looking at books and asking them questions about what's in the books. So you're developing their critical thinking skills. Mm-hmm. That's what schools really are trying to do. It's not memorization and skill building. It's also learning how to think critically.
And then the fifth tip is to build their self-esteem.
Right. This is another important part about going to school, is the social aspects of education, where you learn to get along with other kids and other adults. You learn how to be a leader. And those things really come from you as a parent instilling in them lots of enthusiasm and excitement about their education, so they feel confident when they get there.
All right, Chris, great tips from First Five. Thanks for coming in today.
Sure.
And for more information on all of these kinds of tips, you can call 800-KIDS-025 or log on to kcra.com/morningnews. And we've got a link to First Five California's new parent webpage. You can also follow First Five California on Facebook and Twitter. You tweet?
Yes, I do.
About that. So do we.